And there's Beauty enjoying her evening dinner. She's got some Friskies tuna and egg with her antibiotics in it. And later today, because it's about 4 in the morning right now, and about a little less than 12 hours, she'll be seeing the veterinarian again. Thank you so much, Miss Pickletoes. We're going to see what happens. Here, I'm sick. I can't even see a doctor. But we're more concerned about little Miss Beauty. She's got a little more age on her than I do. Not by much, but for her type of creature, she certainly is older. We're going to find out tomorrow. Hopefully we'll be able to look at her mouth. I don't know. She's very touchy around her head. So we're going to insist, though, that the veterinarian be able to look in there, and I hope she's going to be nice about it, because Miss Beauty has some pain in her ears. Anyway, a little bit more in just a minute. She's just eating away with that little ear on the side. A little crooked head. Hey, Beauty. Hello, baby girl. Hi, baby girl. Hello, beautiful. Is that good tuna and egg? That's good. That's good. She's like, I'm not done eating yet. Just hold on. When I'm finished, I'll let you know. Oh, okay, here she comes, I think. No, she's not feeling her best. Usually she comes right over for attention. So she's not feeling top notch right now. Well, let's see what she does here. She's thinking about it. Can I get some water? Well, she put a hurting on that tuna and egg. She'll eat almost all her can at one sitting. And I don't know too many lady cats that do that. She wanted a little drink of water. And then she rethought that. Not sure what she's going to do right now. Well, we're waiting, Beauty. She stands for a long time thinking about what to do. Come on, baby. What's the matter? I'm going to take her to the doctor and hopefully be able to find out what's really been ailing her for the most. Now she's going to lay back down. She likes the top of my luggage. Oh, she's struggling. She's struggling. There she is. Hello, precious. Having trouble? Come on, precious. There she is. She wants her attention now and her petties. Yeah. What's a precious girl, huh? What's that precious girl thinking? Yes, we know. We love you, Beauty. Aw, she gave me little kisses. Aw. Precious girl. Precious girl. She still wants to wash up. Yeah, precious baby. Okay. Well, maybe that's enough for now. Let's let her take her bath. I've discovered something about Miss Beauty. She likes to be brushed while she eats. She just went straight to her meal. As soon as I started to brush her, somebody used to love this little girl sometime in her life. Somebody used to treat her so well. I don't know what's going on or what happened to her. I'm mystified. How can such a nice, sweet, little inside kitty end up on the street in such a horrible, dirty old place with wild dogs and
unkind people. How can that happen? You know, it doesn't matter how long I've been on this earth. 53 years now. I don't know why I can't get used to the idea that our world can be a very cruel place and very, very bewildering. I don't understand cruelty. There's a line in that movie, Dangerous Liaisons, with John Malkovich and Glenn Close. And she says, somebody in there said deliberate cruelty. That's something that they cannot abide. Deliberate cruelty. And that is something I can't abide. And I know a lot of our cat community out there and my good friends on YouTube and on Facebook feel the same way. It's really up to us to not let the world change us and take the beautiful things that were given to us and our dispositions and personalities. It's up to us to fight that. You see how many old people turn out so bitter and mean and negative. We can't let that happen. Don't let the world win. Don't let it rob you of the kindness and the goodness that the Great Spirit has given you and bestowed in you. Then when you die on your deathbed with love for everybody and everything and forgiveness, because not everyone's on the same path or at the same juncture in their journey, then you don't have to come back and do it over again. You can become part of the light then. And we begin this way. The Bible says something about, you know, do this for the least of my brethren. Well, he didn't say human beings, did he? And I don't think of them as the least, but I think he meant the smallest and the most helpless. And that's what we do, isn't it? That's the kind of people that we are. And that's why we have this happy little creature here, and her happiness is just as important as any human being's. Pain is pain, no matter who's feeling it or what their species. And relief and safety and security and comfort is just as blissful for them as it is for us. And it's a very unselfish thing that Jan has done. And I will always remember her to God for such a kind heart. She is blessed among women. That's how I feel. Beauty's giving herself a bath. She didn't have the coordination to do this last week. So, she's trying. Whenever you scratch near her tail or on her back and her little spine, she starts licking all over her chest because she can't get back there herself. So I've got to take care of it for her. And this is her. She's looking a little better right now because we put her on the antibiotics. But she has diarrhea now. She didn't have that before. So it must be working and, you know, killing off some bad things. So that's Beauty. Washing her little hands. She's looking a little better because of the antibiotics. But thank you, Miss Pickletoes, says Beauty. Because I might not have had such a good chance without you. There are angels in this world. And yes, America, there is a God. There is a God. Just look at this and try and say that there isn't. Thank you, Jan. Thank you, Chris and Chi. And thank you, Kathy, Frutus Maris. And thank you, everyone who's been so concerned. Everybody. And thanks for all the sweet comments. We'll give you an update tomorrow. We're going to record at the veterinarian's. And then we're going to record when we get her back. Find out whatever's going on. Night for now.